to recommend Facebook for stock investor due to its leading position in social media, excellent performance of the historic price, and the company's forward-looking strategies. Hello everyone, my name is Zhendong, and I am a master's student from Stanford University. So today, I would like to talk about my analysis of the Facebook stock. So, I would like to introduce the business operation of the company as well as its stock performance, and then we'll move to the part of the analysis, which will include company strategies and investment risk. Founded in 2004, Facebook is a company that provides social networking surveys in the industry of the internet. And here are some key profiles of the companies. And as we all know that Mark Zuckerberg is the founder and the current CEO. So as of the December 31st in 2015, the Facebook had already got around 1 billion daily active users and around 1.6 billion monthly active users. So how does Facebook earn money? It's advertising. As you can see from the pie chart of the revenue breakdown here, about 95% of advertising, 95% of the total revenue came from the advertising in 2015. And what's more, that these figures have been keeping increasing since 2013. And these phenomena will result in some potential, will face some potential risk, which I will introduce later. And for the yearly revenue growth, just want to highlight, it can reach about 43.82%, which is extremely high. Facebook stock had excellent historical performance. So here are some key statistics about the Facebook stock on April 1st. And the forecast earning growth rate, that's 28%, that this figure is calculated by, estimated by the agency called Vector Vest. I basically extra the data about the monthly stock price from Yahoo Finance, and the year range I choose here came from the May in 2012, which was the first time that Facebook began to sell stocks to publics until the most recent month. And here's a plot. So as you can see on the plot, that the price of the Facebook stock completely rocketed. So from the beginning, it started with the around $30 per share and ends with about over $110 per share. So now I would like to move to the part of the analysis. In my case studies, what makes Facebook stand out is the company's forward-looking strategies. Facebook has already made an extremely Shoo-in acquisition. So in 2012, it purchased Instagram, and this acquisition is considered as extremely successful. It had already got a 400 million monthly active user, which is 18 million more than the Facebook's major competitor, Twitter. And similarly, the acquisition of the WhatsApp is also very, very successful, and it has already started to accumulate revenue for the Facebook. And Facebook is also stepping into the industry of the virtual realities. So in 2014, Facebook purchased Oculus for $2 billion, and it was mentioned in its annual report that Facebook is still planning to invest, continue to invest a significant amount of money into technology for the long-term consideration. And lastly, China. As we all know that the Facebook is currently blocked in China, but that does not mean that Facebook has no business opportunities in China. And apparently, Mark Zuckerberg is spending efforts to port the Chinese market. According to the most recent news, Mark Zuckerberg met the Chinese propaganda chief, and he also got some future plans to release. So let's see what's going to happen. Now I would like to talk about the investment risk. So essentially there are two risks I would like to mention. The first one is ad blocking technologies. If Facebook had increasing advertising percentage of the revenues, and here comes the threat. The one thing I need to point out is the Facebook is not the only company that facing these issues. Google has relatively diverse revenues, but from its annual report, the percentage of the advertising also occupies around 90% in its total revenue. The second risk that Facebook is facing that is the slow growth of the user in the future. So as you can see on this plot here, the growth rate is continually increasing, and this is because that Facebook has already reached a huge number of the user. So mathematically speaking, it is not that much likely that Facebook can reach those high growth again in the foreseeable future. Those two investment risks has already been recognized by the Facebook company. And it also mentioned about in its annual report that the company are seeking some solutions for those potential challenges. And I believe that the Facebook will continue to make some wise strategies to build a robust and healthy business models to generate stable revenue streams. And so in summary, I would recommend Facebook stocks for investors for the long-term interest. Okay, so this is the end of my presentation, and thanks for listening.